Track 10. The Brooklyn Bridge, Construction and Stories. The story of the Brooklyn Bridge's construction is a story of disaster and triumph. Construction took 14 years and cost the lives of 27 men in addition to the original designer, John Roebling. The project began with the sinking of two giant caissons into the river. These were made of wood, floated to their positions, and gradually filled with stone, which caused them to sink deeper and deeper into the water. The workers who went down into these caissons faced the same danger as scuba divers do today, and many died or were injured by what was then called caisson disease when they came up out of the caissons too quickly. One of the men stricken with caisson disease was Washington Roebling, the son who took over the project after his father died working on this bridge. Well, Washington Roebling was forced to supervise the last year of construction from an apartment overlooking the bridge site, and he sent messages to his workers through his wife, Emily, who was given the honor of being the first person to cross the bridge when it was finally finished in 1873. It took 14 years and untold hours of backbreaking, dangerous labor to finish the bridge. Using Roebling's cable spinning machine, workers at the Brooklyn Bridge site had created enough steel rope to connect New York City with Dublin, Ireland. On the day the Brooklyn Bridge finally opened, 150,000 excited people crossed between Manhattan and Brooklyn, marveling at the Gothic granite towers, the spiderweb of suspension cables, and the amazing views of the city and the river. Not long after the bridge opened, tragedy happened again. Nobody knows exactly who screamed, but one busy morning, maybe someone tripped and fell, perhaps someone was startled, but a rumor spread that the bridge was about to collapse. People ran over one another to get off the bridge, and 12 people were trampled to death by the crowds. The Brooklyn Bridge has stood as a silent witness to many changes in New York City. When it was first built, its towers were the tallest structures in the city, though now they are dwarfed by dozens of skyscrapers. The bridge itself has changed a bit over the years, too. In 1950, the bridge stopped carrying train and streetcar traffic, making more room for cars. In 1984, a bicycle lane was added to Roebling's original elevated walkway. These days, over 100,000 cars cross the bridge each day, as well as a few thousand pedestrians and cyclists going to and from work, or perhaps just to see the view from one of the greatest bridges in the world.